Hey guys, welcome back to Ada's Place. My name is Ada and I've actually decided to start this series where I talk about everything related to Germany, coming to Germany, applying for visas, you know, and all of that out of my own personal experience, of course. So in this video, I'm going to be talking about 11 reasons why you should consider coming to Germany as an international student. So if maybe you want to be an international student, you're considering leaving your country to go to another country to study, or you already have options but then you're wondering which one would you go to, which one should you even consider, I hope this video convinces you that Germany is a place for you. I hope. Number one reason why most people would really consider coming to Germany is that here in Germany, there are a lot of tuition-free schools, or at least schools that pay very low tuition fees. You know, here in Germany, 11 out of 16 states actually declared their state universities free, giving people opportunity, irrespective of where they're from, irrespective of if they are, you know, Europeans or non-Europeans, anybody can come. As long as you get admitted into the schools, you can actually come and study for free. However, you should also know that even though you don't pay school fees, like you don't pay the tuition fees, you're also required to pay for your semester dues. When you pay for the semester dues, it actually gives you access to some of the portals or some of the things, some of the privileges that students enjoy. Say for instance, subsidized transport tickets. So when you pay for your semester dues, you can actually go with the proof of payment to the S-Bahn office or the BVG office. So you can go there with this proof and then they would help subsidize your train ticket, so you don't pay the full amount. That's one of the very exciting reasons why you should really consider coming to Germany. Right. Just in case you're not lucky enough to get admitted into some of the schools that are tuition free, depending on your course, because of course there are some courses that you would require to pay a certain amount of fees for. You know, it might not be entirely tuition free, you might actually have to pay a bit of the fees. It might not be the whole fee. Yeah, whichever way, you're not paying the full amount. So there's this option for that as well. And if you're not in any of these schools, you decide to get admitted into a private university, of course the option is there, but private universities are not tuition free. You have to pay the fees, but then again sometimes you can be given a scholarship, a 20% scholarship or a 50% scholarship that actually reduces the amount you have to pay. Schools have the advantages and disadvantages, it just depends on what you decide to go for. Well, at least the good thing is that you have the option of choosing either to go to a tuition-free school or to go to a school that has low tuition fees or to go to a private university. The choice is just for you. The second reason is that if you're worried about, you know, the quality of education here in Germany, please worry no more. We have top quality schools here, like top quality education here. So if you're worried about, you know, the quality of education here since they are free, worry no more, because German schools are ranked among one of the best schools in the world. I mean, free with good quality. What are you waiting for? Well, again, if you're worried about the language barrier and you're concerned about the language you would be taught with, it would please you to know that some schools here in Germany are actually taught in English. Like, they have all their courses in English, their teachers teach in English. Well, their teachers teach in English. Although there are also courses and some schools as well that also teach in German, it just depends on what you want. If you want to come here to actually learn the German language, actually enroll in a language school, and when you're even taught in the German language, it even solidifies it more. But just in case you're too afraid to actually learn in German, there are options for you to learn in English. So when you're checking out for these schools and you're checking out the courses as well, you have to also check the language in which these courses are being taught, so that you don't get admitted into a school that teaches in German hoping to be taught in English. You just have to be really, really careful with that. Okay, so you've watched this point in this video, it means I'm actually keeping you interested, and what I'm saying is actually making sense. So you might want to consider subscribing if you haven't, and please give this video a thumbs up, it really helps me a lot, you know, with my analytics and all that. So it really, really helps me, and it would be really nice if you know, encourage me by giving a thumbs up, liking, commenting. Okay, thumbs up is liking, yeah, commenting and subscribing. Yeah, so let's go back into the video. There are also some private schools that are located in different parts of the world, with branches here in Germany. Just in case you maybe want to go to a school that is originally in France, but you want to go to Germany instead, I mean, you can always search for that option. There are schools here in Germany that aren't born here in Germany, but they're situated here in Germany. Like, they have location, they have branches, subsidiaries here in Germany. So, also, in case if you're worried about how you're going to pay your fees, there are also scholarship options provided by DAAD. That is the German Academic Exchange Service. I'm going to leave the link in the description box below, so you can always check it out. On their website, you can always search for the course you want to study and the language you want to study, and then they give you options. Like, they have different, they have spread of courses. You now choose one that best suits you, you know, in terms of fees, in terms of language, in terms of requirements, you know, to apply into these schools. Now, another very interesting thing about Germany is that they incorporate this diversity. If you look at what the world is turning into right now and how everybody's trying to have this global mindset, Germany gives you that, because here there are tons of international students, people from different countries, not just the EU countries, people from different non-EU regions that are here. So they just want to, you know, get knowledge and they just want to enjoy what Germany offers. And the spread of the courses taught here in Germany allows this, you know, they breed this kind of diversity. So when you're here, you learn to be more diverse, and it will help you in your future career in the workplace, because most of the companies here, they want people that have an international mindset. And if you think again, what is the best way to get the international mindset? If you are an international student studying in an international school, that's where it trains you, you know, right from the start on how to be very international and how to live in an international place and work in an international setting. So if you're looking out for diversity, you're looking to, you know, enjoy other cultures, enjoy other people from other cultures, then Germany is really the place for you. It'll give you that option, for real. Another interesting thing to know for students that are thinking or considering coming to Germany is that here in Germany, students are allowed to work, although part-time. Yeah, students are allowed to work part-time. So you actually have the option of, you know, working and having a little bit of savings for feeding, paying your rent and things like that. This is really good because, you know, most people worry about how they're going to fend for themselves if they don't always have to, you know, ask money from home, or maybe there's an issue and the money doesn't come in really quickly. You have the opportunity to actually work and make some money. And this money can act like, the amount of money you receive can actually pay for the most basic things, feeding, rent and your insurance. Here in Germany, students are allowed to work 20 hours, which is part-time during the semester, and then full-time during the semester breaks. By law, as a student, you're allowed to work for 180 full days in a calendar year, and then 240 half days. So it just depends on how you calculate it, and you try not to exceed that limit because it would affect you in the future, especially when you want to renew your visa. And it's also interesting to know that as a student, there's a minimum wage. The minimum wage here in Germany is 450 euros. So if you're earning 450 euros, which is the least you can earn as a student, you're not going to be taxed on it. But if you earn more than 450 euros, then there is a possibility that you will get taxed on the, you know, extra amount. Yeah, depending on your lifestyle and how much you spend, 450 euros can actually cover some basic needs like feeding, rent and, you know, your insurance. So it just depends on how you spend as a person. It's like the bill everybody pays, like you don't know. You should also know that here in Germany as a student, your courses are actually geared to enable your practice. What I mean by this is that when you're studying, you also have the opportunity to, like, the way the courses are designed gives you the opportunity to actually have the real life experience. Let's try to imbibe some game practices and, you know, things like that to allow you have like a real life experience. This actually helps to bridge the gap of, you know, coming from a very theoretical background without having much practice, and then you come into a job setting and you don't have a clue on what to do. You remember some of the games you did and some of the assignments you did together in a group or as a team. It gives you, it kind of prepares you for what to meet. Another beautiful reason why you should consider coming to Germany as a student is that once you're here as a student, you have the opportunity to, you know, travel around Europe. Like, I mean, who doesn't like traveling? Okay, I'm sure some people don't like traveling, but then again, you have the option to, you know, to travel around Europe. It's so sad that with the pandemic, people are kind of afraid to travel, and like, it's not very easy as it used to be to travel. But then again, you have the option of traveling around. If you're an EU citizen, I'm sure you already know this, but for people that are not EU citizens, if you have a German visa, you're allowed to actually travel within the EU countries without a visa. You don't need to go applying for a visa again to travel within the EU countries. So it's actually a good thing. So you can, during your so during semester breaks, you can, you know, decide to travel, explore Europe, meet the people, see the culture, enjoy the life here in Europe. You have the opportunity to have the whole 360 European experience here. Another reason why Germany is actually a place to be is that it's a very safe country. So if you're worried about your safety, you know, with all the gun violence in some of the schools in different parts of the world, it almost doesn't exist here. The country is really safe. They have measures set in place to keep people safe, not just for EU citizens or German citizens, but for anybody living here. You don't need to worry too much about some of the safety measures. However, you just need to also be careful. You can't live a very careless life hoping to miraculously be safe. You have to also protect yourself. The good thing is that once you protect yourself the least way you can, I mean, the system will actually work. Another reason why studying in Germany is a great option for international students is that once you're done schooling, you have an opportunity. Like, they give you 18 months to actually find a job in your field. I mean, how many countries do that? Here, even after your graduation, you have the opportunity to search for a job. They actually give job-seeking visas. I'm going to do a video on that later as well, so just watch out for that. After your graduation, you have a window time, like a window period, to search for a job in your field, which is really a good thing. So even if you decide to leave the country, and you're still within the 18 months window, you can still come back on a student, on a job seeking visa, so long as you have a valid German certificate, like your certificate shows that you actually studied here in Germany. So it's so good, because most people worry that after spending so much money coming here as an international student, they don't have the opportunity to look for a job and, you know, try to gain their money back. But really, they give you that opportunity, and it's really, really good. I hope this video has convinced you that, you know, coming to Germany as an international student is really a good option. It's something that you should really, really consider, because they just give you a lot of opportunities as an international student, even after your studies here. Hey guys, that's it for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, leave comments on what you want to see next on my channel, and if you've not subscribed, please, you might want to consider subscribing. Also, share this video with your friends, because, you know, some of them might be considering coming to Germany, and now that I'm going to make a series, they really would want to, you know, stay to enjoy and partake of everything I have to give out there. Yeah, so do you really want to enjoy and, you know, learn one or two things from the videos I am going to make? That's it. I'll see you in my next video. Ciao.